How do you feel, Boris? He is in there for life. Hey there, everyone, Dan here from the Diamond Minecart, and welcome back to another episode of Minecraft Xbox 360 Edition. Me and Casper here just wanted to pay Boris a little visit in his prison, and I guess we kind of need to make like a little trapdoor or something so that we can feed him, because I don't want him to die. That's a bit upsetting, but we do need to feed him like little bits of bread, maybe just seeds. We could just feed him seeds and grass, because he stole Casper and took him below the cake empire of the great cake baker, even, and I swear I just saw an Enderman. Did anyone else just see that? There was an Enderman right here. It kind of flitted about, but anyway, we got Casper back, which is the greatest thing. And I want to make quite a big change to the TD Empire today. What I want to do is pretty much have a community that can be fully protected and also be like free roaming as well, because I want them to. I want them to have a full life. They're just kind of sitting in their market stores by themselves. And what I also want are some golems. I really, really want some iron golems. And I can hear, is this chicken still here? Chicken? Yep, he's still here. Let's see how long this guy stays here for. But I really want some golems because they can help protect us. I also want to employ a special ocelot as well to protect us from creepers. And what I'm going to do is I've been researching quite a bit on what counts as a house in a village. Now, apparently, just simply a piece of dirt and then a door counts as a village, or a house even, not a village. And we pretty much, I think, can change these gates to doors, and then we've got four houses straight away. And then we've also got the houses that are over near the, we've got one here, we've got one over there, we've got my house, and I think you need 10 or 11 houses, and no, wait, was it, I can't remember how many it was, but you need a lot of houses. It might have been 21. It might have been 21 houses. I'll check in a bit. But anyway, there's two numbers. There was like a 20 number and a 10 number. And one of them was the amount of villagers. And one of them was the amount of houses. How are you doing, guys? You doing okay? I need to let some of you out, actually. So what I need to do today is build lots of doors and change the gates to doors. Now, that is going to mean that we're going to have some free roaming villagers over here. And hopefully they don't get into too much trouble, because villagers are very pesky and we know that from experience. So let's go and make a little bit of a lever and we can let out some of the clones. And then what we can do is, why do you guys keep moving around? How are you doing, Olivia? How are you doing, Oliver? We'll take you all for a little walk in a sec. And yeah, they all keep moving. It's very strange. But what we need to do is grab some stuff. So I really want to make some kind of farms as well, just because I think that would be quite cool. So an iron golem farm, because again, I keep reminding you guys, so I'm gonna say it again anyway. The Xbox worlds are not infinite, so you don't have an infinite number of supplies. So farms are the best way for us to be able to do that. So we might have to do that in the future. Casper, where are you? There you are, buddy. He just warps into the stairs. Let's let these guys out for a little bit. I'm just gonna have to, is this the best way to do it? I might need, yeah, let's make two levers so that we can walk out and, oh yeah, the sign's here. That's a problem. I might just have to take the sign down for a sec and then replace it after I've put the extra lever down. So I can open the gates, jump in, walk out, and still manage to lock it, if that makes sense. So I'm gonna have to do that. Let's do that right now. So here we go, let's put that there, and this should work, I think, anyway. Let's grab, where is it? It's gonna be here. Yeah, that's fine. Sweet. So let's go and make this so that it's properly efficient, and we're gonna open it from this side. I think that works. So if we unlock this, and then we need to let, not all of them, we need all of them but two to get out of here. Get out of here. Hey, just get out of the machine and you are free. You should be like happy and stuff that you are free from your little chamber that you've been stuck in for ages. Don't be so rude and accept my gift and get out of here. Hopefully none of them go far. I don't think they will, because this counts as a village anyway. And then we'll have a proper empire going when we have iron golems spawning, and then we'll need to make like some brewing potions and stuff. I think that's fine. Let's put them like this. Oh no, it doesn't work. Let's just shut that up here. Nice. So we've got one on each side anyway. It doesn't matter. So these guys should start breeding soon, which is awesome. And now we've got loads of villagers around. This is actually working out really well. I didn't think it would work out this well. We are running out of, oh my god, we're running out of armor pretty quickly. Hopefully we don't have to fight too much. Right then, what we need to do now is grab some doors. Now, this is going to be a strange episode of here, but we did have a lot of action in last week's episode. I mean, oh my god, we had loads. If you haven't checked it out, then you definitely do. It'll be in the previous section of this playlist and or on my channel as well. I think we should go and grab some wood then. Let's go and grab some wood and also think of something else that we need to do on here in the TD Empire, which is, yeah, I guess we should make some more market stalls then. If we need to make sure... Oh, I wonder what that sound was then. It freaked me out. It's all of our animals. But yeah, we need to think about... what we need, how many market stalls we're gonna need, because I need to find out how many houses we're gonna need so that we can get iron golems spawning and making it all look amazing with iron golems. I literally cannot wait. And we also need to go and tame an ocelot, because I know there's a jungle biome. We need to capture some fish, catch some fish and make sure that we can tame one of those. And I think I'll keep it like in a cage, but a really nice cage, so it doesn't feel like we're caging it up, because we don't want to have someone employed under our name and then just keep it in a cage, because then everyone will leave and think I'm a horrible person. So we're not gonna do that. Oh, I already had oak wood on me. How silly of me. But I'm gonna have to make quite a few doors. We've got how many of those have we got? We've got, is it four? Is it four or six? I can't even remember of the market stalls. Oh, the barn will count as one as well. So we'll find villagers literally everywhere. Now, I'm not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing. And on the topic of making a farm, actually, an iron golem farm, is that I really want to make a railway soon, which means we're going to need a ton of iron, and we need it to be renewable, basically. How does this pig get so far out of here? This guy's magic. Absolutely magic. It's crazy. What am I doing? Let's just grab one of these crafting tables. Now, I'm not sure where these guys are going to go when we release them, but we got to find out pretty soon. Let's get rid of these. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we go. This is the big reveal. This is going to pretty much just set them free. And hopefully these count. There they go. They're gone. Hopefully they open them. It seems to work. I think that means it's a house, but let's see if they actually take cover or they just all turn into zombies. This could be the worst decision I've ever made. And we have only got four here, which is a problem. We're just gonna have to make some more. These guys, did you see that? They were like dancing. That was really cute. So what we're gonna have to do is like wait around until nighttime and see if they, oh God, they're all going. They're all going. They hate it here. I think they're off to find houses. I think it's working. I think it's working. Get out of there. Casper, geez. Yeah, it's working. They count as houses. Yes! The big test. That is awesome. It actually works. I'm actually really surprised that that works. We need to light this up a little bit, don't we? Right then. This counts as a house as well. So let me count how many we've got. No one's been in here. We've still got no entry there because of all the shenanigans that happened last time. I won't spoil it for anyone who hasn't seen it. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... 6, 7, 8, 9. That's pretty impressive. Oh, 10, the police station. And maybe 11 counts as a house over there. So we've got 10 at least, which is pretty damn good, actually. That's impressive. And I'm going to quickly check the villager rules in a second. Let's have a quick sleep. Oh, no. Oh, no. Where is it? No. We don't want this to happen. We don't want this to happen. No! Where is that? Right. Come and help me. Help me. Casper, help me. Help me. We need to get rid of these guys because we do not want... oh, God, no! The villagers! Oh, no! Right, let's see if we can sleep and save the villagers. Quick, run in here, guys. Run in here. Why aren't they running in here? Oh, wow, we almost had a real problem there because they can actually get infected now into zombie villagers, which would be terrible. We don't want that to happen. We don't want that to happen at all. Casper was pretty useless, but he has had a busy day, a busy few days. And I have just had a look quickly at that little break, and we need 21 houses. It's 10 villagers at least, and then 21 houses. Are you kidding me? That is so many houses. I can't believe it. Oh, no, I'm stuck. Why did I do this? Why do I do this? Let's make sure they don't get out. No, Casper, don't you get stuck as well. So we need 21 houses. We've definitely got 10 villages at least. I mean, wow, we have a lot. And someone keeps breaking their legs. I don't want to know about that. But we need to make 21 houses now. These guys look happy. It's really cool, actually, that we can have them. Oh, wait, wait. Does that count as a house? The Mystic Hat counts as a house, too. That's awesome. Where did my bread go? Nope, that's a fence. We need to eat some bread. So we need to get going and making some more market stalls because at least they count as houses. As long as the villagers go in, they count as houses. So if we make like another couple of, let's make some more market stalls. We need to get loads of this going. I really, really want some golems, but I also want to make some snow golems as well, just so we've got ultimate protection. So in this episode, we need to harvest some snow, and we also need to tame an ocelot and try and get it over here so that it scares away all the creepers and maybe light up the world a little bit more with some lamps, but that's a questionable one. I'm only going to bring Casper with me today because I don't want him to get in the way too much. Look at him just poking his nose through the door. That's so weird, Casper. Really weird. It looks like a face. Look, you take the door handles and the snout, it kind of... it looks very strange. But what we're going to need is a lot of wood because we need to make as much of this as possible. So let's grab... is there any more? There's some stairs in here which we can use. There's some slabs. And we need to decide on some more colours. Oh, wait, have we got any fences? I think we've got some in our inventory, but have we got any more? We have... yes, we do. Oh, we have so much oak wood. I don't know why I went and got some more. But anyway, that's fine. We need some signs, and we also need... oh, we got some wool here. I didn't even know. Let me grab these crafting tables too. Let me put this wall back for now, and we've run out of space in our valuables chest. How is that even possible? Anyway... let's go ahead and make some more of these because they're going to look absolutely fantastic. Look at all these guys. It's really cool having like a bustling community. It really is. We finally got these lamps sorted out. I'm going to have to make some new ones. So in between there is a gap of three in between. So we need to go 1, 2, 3. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. You're in the way. 1, 2, 3, and then boom. And then we need to make, get out of the way, torch, please. Then we need to put, how many is it across? It's 3 stairs and then 1 more. So we're going to need to cover over this little bit. But this is our way into we've taken out all the gravel in here because that was something that we needed. And this is our way down into our kind of empire. So what we're going to have to do is cover over some of it, but leave the hole that we need. So let's cover over this. There we go. Just so that we can get some building going down and that we don't... Just need to make sure we don't cover up. I think it's this hole. Yeah, that hole down there. That's our main way into kind of the underground parts. So we don't want to do that. And then we need to leave a gap for the door. 1 here. 2. And then is it 1 more? It is 1 more. And then we need to go across as well. So there we go. This is slowly being created. Yay. So we need to just put this here. No, just put it here. Thank you. This here, this guy wants to move in already, and then what we can do is have another comments competition and see who can name, who wants to name this. That'd be awesome, that'd be really cool. I think we need birch wood as well. I don't have any on me, but we'll get to that later. So we've got one here, let's put down a crafting table as well. And we need to make a couple more, because we need 21 houses. I guess when we get to building more of the TD Empire as well, we'll have... some more house material, but I want to kind of include the cake bakery in this because it's kind of sitting there by itself and it needs some company, so we're going to do that right now. And we're also going to get more trades as well if people are walking around enjoying themselves. But I need to be aware that I need to complete my goals as well, which is taming an ocelot and grabbing some snow as well. Excuse me, Casper, I just need to use this space a second. 1, 2, 3, there we go. And then we need 1, and we need to use a crafting table. Come here. It looks like a proper construction place here. Everything's like half finished and it looks really cool. There we go, that'll do for now. Boom, boom, there we go. And this here, we need to make it back a little bit further. So we need to be careful of this. I need like a better way to get down. I might make kind of like a trap door and then make it go down. Kind of like Boris's lair, but on the way down to something good rather than something terrifying. Dog recipe, literally terrifying. Let's put this here and then grab these, put that there, this here. This here, and then this here, and that is a second one, which is cool. Let's cuisine it with a crafting table. But these could move because it depends what you guys decide them to be in the comments below. So if I forget at the end of this episode, you need to comment down below what you want these to be and what color as well. None of these colors so far, we kind of want it as colorful as possible. So we've already used dark blue, we've used orange, we've used yellow, and we've used red as well. So we need 2 more market stalls. You need a name, actually it can be just your name, and then also you need what it's going to be, so what it's going to sell, what kind of service it's going to provide to the TD Empire, and also a color of wool as well, making sure it doesn't conflict with any of these, and that should be so sweet. Right then, what have we got to do now? We kind of need to make... we need to make doors. Is that... I swear I was going to do that before, but I think I made stairs instead. Door. And I think that I will actually count as a house as it stands right now, but not a very safe one, really, is it? To be honest. So this is... Oh, this is coming along nicely. We are extending the TD Empire, and we kind of need something here. I might put... Should we put another market stall here? Let's go for it. We're going for three. Three market stalls. It's going to be awesome. We need a way for them to get in. So we one, two, here. One more there, and then here. And then there'll be a gap there for the door, and across here as well. Sweet. So we've got lots of market stalls now. Careful. Jeez, careful, Casper. You're going to get chopped with an axe. That'd be terrifying. All that effort to save you, and then you get chopped by an axe. We definitely don't want that to happen, do we? That would be terrible. Right, let's put this here, and this here. We also need to christen this with a door and a crafting table. So let's grab a door and a crafting table. And is that all our wood used up? Almost. We've almost used up all our wood. That's I can't believe we've done that already. And oh no, I've put that in the wrong place. I fell in the water. There we go. That is another house christened. So these doors will probably have to change, or they will be broken later on, because I need to update the bottoms. Oh, he's having a little swim, a joyous swim. And look, that villager's just checking him out like, what a happy dog. He is a very happy dog. I just need to grab some more stairs. I don't know if I can craft them yet. I can now. There we go. That is another one. So now we need three different ones. So one idea per comment, and please only comment like once with your best ideas, so that I can get three different people to have different things in the TD Empire. I'm excited. I am so excited. Look at all this expansion that's going on. Can we get to that well? Yeah, we can. We can get it right round here. Awesome. So this is filling up beautifully. What we also need to do now is go and complete our other quests, which are to... Oh no! The chicken is moved! Look at these guys! They kind of moved the... Oh no! Oh no, this is... this is terrible. We need to help them out. Guys... This isn't really like a public swimming bath. You need help. You need help to get out of here. So please just use the ladder provided or the little step provided. And just please stop swimming in our river. It's kind of weird. Are these guys gonna be able to get out? I'm worried now. I'm worried. But anyway, we're going to have to leave them there for a bit. Oh, they're getting stuck all over the place. He's stuck in a whirlpool. We're going to have to sort that guy out, but we'll save them later on. We're going to have to employ a lifeguard or something like that. And let me just quickly grab all of this wheat, because that's a lot of wheat. And then in the final, third of the video, what we're going to do is make sure we get our second challenges complete. So we're going to need to take some fish with us. We're going to need to visit Trout & Co. to grab some raw fish. We might even have to capture one ourselves, or a couple ourselves, just in case we don't have enough raw fish. I'm not sure if they sell raw or cooked fish. They should really sell, like, a combination of the two. That would be handy, wouldn't it? I think they will do, though. Let's do this. I think they have, like, a furnace facility so that you can... They sell raw fish, but for an extra fee, you can kind of get them cooked as well, which I guess is kind of cool. Right then, let's just redo all this. Sorry about the little chores, but we kind of have to do them before we go adventuring, because that's what adventurers do. They do their chores, and then they go out and do what they need to do. that is the code of the TD Empire. So let's just quickly do this, and then grab an ocelot. It's going to be quite hard to get it all the way home, I think, and get it into some kind of cage, but when you've tamed them, you can make them sit and stuff, so hopefully we'll be able to do that. And we have a lot of wheat. Wow. This is like the best wheat farm ever. It's not even... I guess it's... It could be even bigger if we wanted it to. But right now, it's making us enough bread to last us a lifetime. And the villagers don't really eat too much. Apart from Boris, who's going to be forced to eat, seeds and grass and stuff. We'll feed him some of that later because he's a little punk. And we're almost done. Come on, a couple more. And then we'll go and deposit this and prepare for our second journey. In this episode, let's go, and of course Casper will come with us. We might need to sleep as well, and just to make sure we don't get caught at night time, because that would be terrifying. And if we just make some bread, just make some foods, let's see how much we can make. Let's just make, like, there we go, that'll do. And then put the rest of the wheat in here. Look at all that wheat! We have so much! It's crazy! And we just need to pop to bed. Oh, how are you doing, sir? How are you doing? It's not Boris, don't worry, guys. He's dressed similarly, but it's not Boris. So what we're going to do now is prepare for our brand new adventure. So let's, are you okay? Can you not leave the door open, please? It makes it very breezy in here and very cold. Thank you for your cooperation. What are we gonna need to take with us? Let's get rid of some stuff we don't need. Let's get rid of this rotten flesh, this string. We need some foods. We don't really need all this wood, but I guess I can take it with me anyway, just because. And I think we're done. What do we need? We need fish. So we need to collect fish and we need a shovel. Got enough of that. We might need another shovel, so let's just make one just in case. Let's put one. I don't have all the ingredients. I don't have a stick. I have all the iron, but I don't have a stick. That's terrible. There we go. Let's go grab some fish and then we'll be on our way. We do need our map because we need to find out where we're going. Come on, Casper, let's go. You are chosen for this one. Let me just go and grab some raw fish and or catch them. I might have to, like, put them out of stock and then make sure. Did they get out in the end? They did. That's good. Apart from this guy. This is really awkward, sir. You're just going to stay there forever. At least they don't drown. I thought they did drown, but at least they can get out. We're just going to have to sort out those whirlpools. They're pesky. Right then, what was I doing? I need to visit Trout & Co. How are you doing, guys? Let's go in here and find... Okay, they've got quite a lot, so we're just going to take all of it. And let's take this just in case we need to capture some more. But I think we might be okay. So let's go, Casper. Let's go and fight what we need to fight and find what we need to find. Let's go. I can see the snow biome over here. I hope you don't scare off... Oh, it probably wasn't a great idea to bring a dog, because dogs and cats just don't mix, do they? They don't mix whatsoever. And I'm not sure how many fish this is going to take to tame an ocelot. But he, whoever is chosen for a really important job. It needs to protect the TD Empire from creepers and scare them off. It's going to be awesome. It'd be really good if there were leads in this version of Minecraft. I know that there aren't. Hopefully in the future there will be leads. Because we have some slime balls, I think. But for now, we're just going to have to deal with it. Let's create some of these. Come on. So what we're doing this for is so that we can have some snow golems at least in the next episode to be able to... I thought I saw a name tag then. That was weird. But so that we can make some snow golems in preparation or just to buy time and give some protection for... Oh, wait, I need some pumpkins. I'm going to need some pumpkins, so hopefully we can find some of those too. Or some pumpkin seeds. We might have some of those. But just so we can buy time until we get iron golems... Why do I keep seeing a name tag? I don't know why I keep seeing a name tag. That's strange. I hope there isn't anyone else in here. That'd be strange. Really strange. I should have opened up more space for these snowballs. So what I'm doing is collecting them so that we have enough to make snow golems, but also a place for them to stay. Oh, I thought they're name tags. It's like the breaking of the blocks. It's okay. We're not being stalked. It's absolutely fine. Ah, my shovel broke. Good job. I made another one then. So yeah, we're going to make snow golems in the next episode. Hopefully have enough so that we can make iron golems and have them spawn. That would be sweet, wouldn't it? And oh no, I'm so... Oh no. See, this is what happens when you get in the way, Casper. I'll have to feed him some meat when we get back. Right, then that should be enough for now. And now we need to get back over to the jungle biome, which I believe is... Yeah, it's right over here. Nice, let's go. Come on, Casper. Don't hurt yourself, though, because I've whacked you with an iron shovel. At least it wasn't a sword, otherwise he'd be, like, half dead by now, which is terrifying. We should have enough time to tame an ocelot. It takes a long time. I know it takes a long time to tame an ocelot. And hopefully we have enough fish. If we don't, that is a problem, and we won't be able to complete our quest for today, which is terrible. We can't not have that. And we also need to find some. Where are the ocelots at? Come on, then. Let's see if we can find the ocelots. Are there any around here? It's a really hilly jungle biome, too. Which means we could struggle to find some on the ground. Where are you? Where are you? Let's see if we can find some. We're on the hunt for ocelots. Me and Oscar. Oscar? No, that is completely wrong. That was kind of like Casper and Oliver mixed together. I meant Casper. Sorry, buddy. Where are you? There you go. He's in the shadows. Oh, there's one. I saw one. Right, you might want to... Okay, he can come with us. So it's going to be awkward because it's on the side of a mountain. But there it is. Look, this is our chosen one. The chosen ocelot. Hey, buddy. Let's crouch and see if we can get... Here he comes. Here he comes. Don't fall, though. Please don't fall. Oh, no, he's fallen. Please don't fall. I kind of need to get down on his level. Ocelot. Ocelot, how you doing, buddy? He's stuck in some leaves right now. Hello, I would like to tame you. How are you doing that? Ocelot, no, don't run away. Don't run away. Please, I have fish. I have fish. Oh, here he comes. Here he comes. He's coming through the water. This could be it. This could be it. Come on, swim faster, buddy. Swim faster. This could be it. Don't ruin this. Don't ruin this. Here we go. Come on. Don't take more than 9. Yes, we done it. Animal can't enter love mode. Oh, wait, what? The maximum number of breeding pigs, sheep, cows, and cats have been reached. What? We've bred too many animals. Too many animals. We have a cat, though. Yes. Right, we need to get back before it gets dark. I need to eat. And hopefully these guys will be friends. Are you going to follow me? Come on, let's follow. Come on. I wish it was a ginger one. I really wanted a ginger cat. But anyway, we can't have everything, can we? And hopefully these guys will follow me home. If they don't, then they're going to be lost forever. Where did he go? Where'd Casper go? Casper? Cat? Come on. We need to name the cat as well. But I won't do that this episode. This episode is reserved for comments for the 3 market stalls. So do not name the cat in this episode. We'll do that next episode. Cat? Cat? We'll just call it cat for now. I worry that we've lost the cat. We did set it to walk. Oh, there he is. He's okay. Don't hurt yourself. I can hear him kind of moaning. I hope that's not because it's hurting itself. Let's get back to the TD Empire. Your brand new home, little cat. Have we got them both? Yeah, look at them. Yes, beautiful. I really wanted a different color cat, though. Can we change them? Do we change their colors? Like, can we dye them? I wish we could dye them. I get a nice bright orange dye and dye them. But anyway, let's come and go back to the TD Empire. We are kind of heading in the right way. We need to go this way. Calm down, cat. It's okay. He's a very happy cat. Where did I put my fish? He just about took enough fish. I thought for a second I was going to have to fish for some more, but we did complete our two goals or our challenges for this episode, which were to get snow so that we can make some snow golems, and we need some pumpkins, actually. I don't know if we have any of those, but we need some pumpkin seeds so we can make a pumpkin farm. That'd be ideal. And we also tamed a cat, which is awesome. So let's go. Let's go back to the TD Empire. Your brand new home, little cat. Now, do we keep it caged up or do we just leave it sitting somewhere? We should make a throne. Oh, we should make a throne for it. That'd be sweet because it is going to be like the creeper overlord because it's going to get all of those creepers out of here. We should make it a throne in the next episode. What should we make it out of, though? I'm happy that you're out, Mr. Chicken. It didn't last too long, did it? This guy's still stuck. How's the other guy doing? The other guy. Still stuck. Little punk. Anyway, we're getting near the end of the episode. I think I'm going to end it out here when we get our cat back and Casper safely back into the house. How are you doing, guys? What are you doing in here? Man. Right, let's get these guys back in here. Come on, guys. Back into here, and we need to make a cat throne. How are you doing? Get these to sit down. Sit down. No, don't leave. Don't leave. We need you to kind of move along here. There we go. I don't know why Casper's gone all dark, but he must have just like trod in mud or something from earlier. But anyway, I'm going to end out this episode here. Thank you so much for watching, guys. We got a lot done today. Woof. And remember, I almost forgot. And remember that you need to leave your comment down below with the name of the market stall you want, your name, and also a color, which isn't any of the colors over there, which is orange, yellow, red, and dark blue. So any of those colors you can't use, leave your comment down below, and maybe yours will be one of the 3 that is chosen in next time's episode. Thank you so much again for watching. If you did enjoy, then please do leave a like. And if this happens to be the first video that you see by me, then please do subscribe for daily Minecraft videos on both PC and Xbox as well. Thank you so much for watching again, guys, and I will see you all next time. Goodbye! How do you feel, Boris? He is in there for life. Hey there, everyone, Dan here from the Diamond Minecart, and welcome back to another episode of Minecraft Xbox 360 Edition. Me and Casper here just wanted to pay Boris a little visit in his prison, and I guess we kind of need to make like a little trapdoor or something so that we can feed him, because I don't want him to die. That's a bit upsetting, but we do need to feed him like little bits of bread, maybe just seeds. We could just feed him seeds and grass, because he stole Casper and took him below the cake empire, or the great cake bakery even, and I just saw an Enderman. Did anyone else just see that? There was an Enderman right here. It kind of flitted about. But anyway, we got Casper back, which is the greatest thing. And I want to make quite a big change to the TD Empire today. What I want to do is pretty much have a community that can be fully protected and also be like free roaming as well, because I want them to. I want them to have a full life. They're just kind of sitting in their market stalls by themselves. And what I also want are some golems. I really, really want some iron golems. And I can hear, is this chicken still here? Chicken? Yep, he's still here. Let's see how long this guy stays here for. But I really want some golems because they can help protect us. I also want to employ a special ocelot as well to protect us from creepers. And what I'm going to do is, I've been researching quite a bit on what counts as a house in a village. Now, apparently, just simply a piece of dirt and then a door counts as a village. Or a house even, not a village. And we pretty much, I think, can change these gates to doors, and then we've got four houses straight away. And then we've also got the houses that are over near the, we've got one here, we've got one over there, we've got my house, and I think you need 10 or 11 houses. I can't remember how many it was, but you need a lot of houses. It might have been 21. It might have been 21 houses. I'll check in a bit. But anyway, there's two numbers. There was like a 20 number and a 10 number, and one of them was the amount of villagers, and one of them was the amount of houses. How are you doing, guys? You doing okay? I need to let some of you out, actually. So what I need to do today is build lots of doors and change the gates to doors. Now, that is going to mean that we're going to have some free roaming villagers over here. And hopefully they don't get into too much trouble, because villagers are very pesky, and we know that from experience. So let's go and make a little bit of a lever, and we can let out some of the clones. And then what we can do is, why do you guys keep moving around? How are you doing, Olivia? How are you doing, Oliver? We'll take you all for a little walk in a sec. And yeah, they all keep moving. It's very strange. But what we need to do is grab some stuff. So I really want to make some kind of farms as well, just because I think that would be quite cool. So an iron golem farm, because again, I keep reminding you guys, so I'm going to say it again anyway. The Xbox worlds are not infinite, so you don't have an infinite number of supplies. So farms are the best way for us to be able to do that. So we might have to do that in the future. Casper, where are you? There you are, buddy. He just warps into the stairs. Let's let these guys out for a little bit. I'm just going to have to... Is this the best way to do it? I might need... Yeah, let's make two levers so that we can walk out and... Oh yeah, the sign's here. That's a problem. I might have to take the sign down for a sec and then replace it after I've put the extra lever down. So I can open the gates, jump in, walk out, and still manage to... lock it, if that makes sense. So I'm gonna have to do that. Let's do that right now. So here we go. Let's put that there, and this should work, I think, anyway. Let's grab, where is it? It's gonna be here. Yeah, that's fine. Sweet. So let's go and make this so that it's properly efficient, and we're gonna open it from this side. I think that works. So if we unlock this, and then we need to let, not all of them, we need to all of them but two to get out of here. Get out of here. Hey, just get out of the machine and you are free. You should be like happy and stuff that you are free from your little chamber that you've been stuck in for ages. Don't be so rude and accept my gift and get out of here. Hopefully none of them go far. I don't think they will, because this counts as a village anyway. And then we'll have a proper empire going when we have iron golems spawning, and then we'll need to make like some brewing potions and stuff. I think that's fine. Let's put them like this. Oh no, it doesn't work. Let's just shut that up here. Nice. So we've got one on each side anyway. It doesn't matter. So these guys should start breeding soon, which is awesome. And now we've got loads of villagers around. This is actually working out really well. I didn't think it would work out this well. We are running out of... Oh my god, we're running out of armor pretty quickly. Hopefully we don't have to fight too much. Right then, what we need to do now is grab some doors. Now, this is going to be a strange episode of here, but we did have a lot of action in last week's episode. I mean, Oh my god, we had loads. If you haven't checked it out, then you definitely do. It'll be in the previous section of this playlist and or on my channel as well. I think we should go and grab some wood then. Let's go and grab some wood and also think of something else that we need to do on here in the TD Empire, which is, yeah, I guess we should make some more market stalls then. If we need to make sure... Oh, I wonder what that sound was then. It freaked me out. It's all of our animals. But yeah, we need to think about... what we need, how many market stalls we're gonna need, because I need to find out how many houses we're gonna need so that we can get iron golems spawning and making it all look amazing with iron golems. I literally cannot wait. And we also need to go and tame an ocelot, because I know there's a jungle biome. We need to capture some fish, catch some fish and make sure that we can tame one of those. And I think I'll keep it like in a cage, but a really nice cage, so it doesn't feel like we're caging it up, because we don't want to have someone employed under our name and then just keep it in a cage, because then everyone will leave and think I'm a horrible person. So we're not gonna do that. Oh, I already had oak wood on me. How silly of me. But I'm gonna have to make quite a few doors. We've got how many of those have we got? We've got, is it four? Is it four or six? I can't even remember of the market stalls. Oh, the barn will count as one as well. So we'll find villagers literally everywhere. Now, I'm not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing. And on the topic of making a farm, actually, an iron golem farm, is that I really want to make a railway soon, which means we're going to need a ton of iron, and we need it to be renewable, basically. How does this pig get so far out of here? This guy's magic. Absolutely magic. It's crazy. What am I doing? Let's just grab one of these crafting tables. Now, I'm not sure where these guys are going to go when we release them, but we got to find out pretty soon. Let's get rid of these. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we go. This is the big reveal. This is going to pretty much just set them free. And hopefully these count. There they go. They're gone. Hopefully they open them. It seems to work. I think that means it's a house, but let's see if they actually take cover or they just all turn into zombies. This could be the worst decision I've ever made. And we have only got four here, which is a problem. We're just gonna have to make some more. These guys, did you see that? They were like dancing. That was really cute. So what we're gonna have to do is like wait around until nighttime and see if they, oh God, they're all going. They're all going. They hate it here. I think they're off to find houses. I think it's working. I think it's working. Get out of there. Casper, geez. Yeah, it's working. They count as houses. Yes! The big test. That is awesome. It actually works. I'm actually really surprised that that works. We need to light this up a little bit, don't we? Right then. This counts as a house as well. So let me count how many we've got. No one's been in here. We've still got no entry there because of all the shenanigans that happened last time. I won't spoil it for anyone who hasn't seen it. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9. That's pretty impressive. Oh, 10, the police station. And maybe 11 counts as a house over there. So we've got 10 at least, which is pretty damn good, actually. That's impressive. And I'm going to quickly check the villager rules in a second. Let's have a quick sleep. Oh, no. Oh, no. Where is it? No. We don't want this to happen. We don't want this to happen. No! Where is that? Right. Come and help me. Help me. Casper, help me. Help me. We need to get rid of these guys because we do not want... oh, God, no! The villagers! Oh, no! Right, let's see if we can sleep and save the villagers. Quick, run in here, guys. Run in here. Why aren't they running in here? Oh, wow, we almost had a real problem there because they can actually get infected now into zombie villagers, which would be terrible. We don't want that to happen. We don't want that to happen at all. Casper was pretty useless, but he has had a busy day, a busy few days. And I have just had a look quickly at that little break, and we need 21 houses. It's 10 villages at least, and then 21 houses. Are you kidding me? That is so many houses. I can't believe it. Oh, no, I'm stuck. Why did I do this? Why do I do this? Let's make sure they don't get out. No, Casper, don't you get stuck as well. So we need 21 houses. We've definitely got 10 villages at least. I mean, wow, we have a lot. And someone keeps breaking their legs. I don't want to know about that. But we need to make 21 houses now. These guys look happy. It's really cool, actually, that we can have them. Oh, wait, wait. Does that count as a house? The Mystic Hat counts as a house, too. That's awesome. Where did my bread go? Nope, that's a fence. We need to eat some bread. So we need to get going and making some more market stalls because at least they count as houses. As long as the villagers go in, they count as houses. So if we make like another couple of... let's make some more market stalls. We need to get loads of this going. I really, really want some golems. But I also want to make some snow golems as well, just so we've got ultimate protection. So in this episode, we need to harvest some snow, and we also need to tame an ocelot and try and get it over here so that it scares away all the creepers and maybe light up the world a little bit more with some lamps, but that's a questionable one. I'm only going to bring Casper with me today because I don't want him to get in the way too much. Look at him just poking his nose through the door. That's so weird, Casper. Really weird. It looks like a face. Look, you take the door handles and the snout, it kind of... it looks very strange. But what we're going to need is a lot of wood because we need to make as much of this as possible. So let's grab... is there any more? There's some stairs in here which we can use. There's some slabs. And we need to decide on some more colours as well. Oh, wait, have we got any fences? I think we've got some in our inventory, but have we got any more? We have... yes, we do. Oh, we have so much oak wood. I don't know why I went and got some more. But anyway, that's fine. We need some signs, and we also need... oh, we got some wool here. I didn't even know. Let me grab these crafting tables too. Let me put this wall back for now, and we've run out of space in our valuables chest. How is that even possible? Anyway... let's go ahead and make some more of these because they're going to look absolutely fantastic. Look at all these guys. It's really cool having like a bustling community. It really is. We finally got these lamps sorted out. I'm going to have to make some new ones. So in between there is a gap of three in between. So we need to go 1, 2, 3. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. You're in the way. 1, 2, 3, and then boom. And then we need to make, get out of the way, torch, please. Then we need to put, how many is it across? It's 3 stairs and then 1 more. So we're going to need to cover over this little bit. But this is our way into we've taken out all the gravel in here because that was something that we needed. And this is our way down into our kind of empire. So what we're going to have to do is cover over some of it, but leave the hole that we need. So let's cover over this. There we go. Just so that we can get some building going down and that we don't... Just need to make sure we don't cover up. I think it's this hole. Yeah, that hole down there. That's our main way into kind of the underground parts. So we don't want to do that. And then we need to leave a gap for the door. 1 here. 2. And then is it 1 more? It is 1 more. And then we need to go across as well. So there we go. This is slowly being created. Yay. So we need to just put this here. No, just put it here. Thank you. This here, this guy wants to move in already, and then what we can do is have another comments competition and see who can name, who wants to name this. That'd be awesome, that'd be really cool. I think we need birch wood as well. I don't have any on me, but we'll get to that later. So we've got one here. Let's put down a crafting table as well. I need to make a couple more because we need 21 houses. I guess when we get to building more of the TD Empire as well, we'll have some more house material. But I want to kind of include the cake bakery in this because it's kind of sitting there by itself and it needs some company. So we're going to do that right now. And we're also going to get more trades as well if people are walking around enjoying themselves. But I need to be aware that I need to complete my goals as well, which is taming an ocelot and grabbing some snow as well. Excuse me, Casper, I just need to use this space a second. 1, 2, 3, there we go. And then we need 1, and we need to use a...